joy, peace, and we become pleasing to God. Jesus came for three primary reasons: to make you pleasing to God, and because of that position where you are now pleasing to God perpetually, you will experience two primary fundamental emotions: peace and joy. Does that remind you of a scripture? Romans chapter 14, verse 17, Paul writes to the Romans and he reminds them that the king has a domain. The king has a kingdom. Oh, do not be fooled by the little baby Jesus in a feeding trough. Remember, he is a king and he comes to establish a domain, otherwise known as a kingdom. And that kingdom is defined by the three gifts he brings. For the kingdom of God, Romans 14, 17 says, is not eating or drinking. It's not external as much as it is internal. It is righteousness, peace, and joy. That little baby Jesus in that manger, in our beautiful nativity scenes, let us not forget, he is a strong, perfect champion, victorious king who comes to extend his domain, and his domain is defined by three gifts: righteousness, peace, and joy. Righteousness, that's the first gift Jesus gives to all who simply receive the claims he makes about himself. If you will receive Jesus as Savior and Messiah, you are gifted righteousness. 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, he who knew no sin became sin so that we might become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Righteousness is a big word. Do you know what it means? It means you are right with God, period. End of story. It's finished. Some of us wonder sometimes, based on our performance, whether or not we're still in good standing with God. Is God far from me? God seems distant. God seems like he's mad at me. God seems like he's frowning on me. And we superimpose our instability and our emotional roller coaster of an existence, and we place it upon God, and we believe to ourselves that my performance can make God mad at me. But if your performance can't save you, your performance can't unsave you. For God is not pleased with you because of what you've done. God is pleased with you because of what Jesus has done. And when you believe in Jesus, your life is hidden in Christ. And when the Father sees you, he sees his Son who is perfect. Therefore, you are always pleasing to God, no matter what you did this last week. And some of you cuss some people out at the mall. I can see it all over your face. Right? I mean, this is the good news. Peace for all those with whom he is pleased. Who is he pleased with? For all have sinned and fallen short of God's glory standard. So who is God pleased with? He's pleased with his Son. For the Bible says, while Jesus hung on the cross, the Father turned away from the Son. And that's why Jesus uttered one of the six statements or seven statements, the 6 hours he hung on the cross was, my God, why have you forsaken me? For the Father looked away from the Son so he could look to you. So he who knew no sin became sin. He took your sin, my sin, forever, without end. Your sin you did yesterday, the sin you do today, and the sin you may do tomorrow, it's all been forgiven. It's all been forgotten. And now you are left simply with right relationship with God that knows no end. That's good news. You are right with God.